WP All Import is a great plugin that allows you to import pages, posts, custom post types, and even WooCommerce products to your website from an XML or a CSV file. In this tutorial, we will show you how to import multilingual content to your site, so let's get started. First, you need to install and activate the WPML Core plugins along with the WPML All Import add-on, which you can find in the Downloads section of your WPML account. Of course, you need to have the WP All Import plugin active as well. Now, let's say that you want to import some posts along with their translations to your website. For that, you need to prepare two CSV files. One includes the content in the default language, and the other includes the translated content of these posts. You can use any spreadsheet editing software that can save files in CSV format, like Google Sheets and OpenOffice. I'm using Microsoft Excel here. This is the English spreadsheet, which includes the default language content. If we open it, you see that it has three posts, and for each post, we have a title, the post category, and the content. The connector column here is used to connect the post of the default language with its translation in the secondary language spreadsheet. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to open both files side by side here. As you can see, the Spanish spreadsheet includes the translated content. By looking at the connector column, you can tell which post is the translation of another by matching the connector cell numbers. Feel free to name the connector column anything you want. The most important thing is you use the same column name in both files and use the same unique ID to connect the row with its translation. At this point, our spreadsheets are ready. Simply save them in CSV format to be imported later. Before importing the posts and their translations, we want to create the exact same categories that are assigned to our posts and translate them. I have already created the default language post categories that match the ones in my CSV file. To translate these categories, navigate to WPML, Taxonomy Translation, and choose Categories from the drop-down menu. I have already translated the fashion and the travel categories. Now let's translate the food category together. When filling the translation, make sure that it matches the translation of the category in the Spanish CSV file that we will import. Now it's time to import the files that we have prepared. Navigate to All Import, then New Import. Click the Upload a File button and fetch the default language file. We are importing posts here, so we will keep the settings as is and continue to step 2. In this screen, you will see the posts that will be imported. Let's go to step 3. Simply use the drag and drop editor to map the title and the content. Scroll down and expand the WPML All Import section and choose the language of the content that you're importing. Now, let's expand the taxonomies, categories, and tags section. As we did with the title and the content, we will map the categories. Let's continue to step 4. Set the unique identifier by clicking on the Auto Detect button. Hit the Continue button and run the import. Now that our import is complete, let's take a look at the imported English posts. As you can see, the posts aren't translated yet. If we go to the editing screen of any post, we can see that the title, content, and post category are imported. Now, let's go ahead and import the file that includes the Spanish translation of the posts. Again, we're adding new posts. Let's continue to step 2. This time, the posts include the Spanish content. Go to the next step and map the title and the content as we did for the English posts. Expand the WPML All Import section, and this time we will choose Spanish. Now, expand the Automatic Record Matching to translate. Under the records matching logic, choose the define parent import option. Then choose the file that includes the posts in the default language. In the unique identifier field, drag and drop the element that you set to be the translation connector. In our example, it's the connector column. Scroll to the taxonomies, categories, and tags section, then drag and drop the category element and move to step 4. Again, click on the Auto Detect button to fill the unique identifier, then run the import. Now, let's go and check if the post translations are actually connected. The pencil icon here indicates that the posts are translated. If we open the translated post editing screen, you can see that all the post elements that we imported are there. To import WooCommerce products, you need to get the pro version of WP All Import along with the WooCommerce add-on. You can find links to both plugins in the description of this video. Importing WooCommerce products is very similar to importing posts. You need to import a CSV or an XML file that includes the product information in the default language, then import the file that includes the translations. In the description, you'll find the link to a nice tutorial by the WP All Import team that explains the process of importing WooCommerce products. With that, we learned together how to use WP All Import on multilingual sites. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.